It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And on this week's show, it's coming up for Black Friday, isn't it?
Well, we got black, every product's black, black jeans on, black top on. The only person letting the team down is this fella here.
So yeah, Black Friday, and that raises quite an interesting point, because we made a bit of a mistake at World Magic Shop. Google told us it was Black Friday last week. I think we had a couple of emails, and we thought, oh, it's Black Friday, so we did this discount code thing, which lots of people took advantage of. So congratulations to you people that got some early deals, but it's not Black Friday till this week, so... stay tuned to the World Magic Shop Facebook page for this week's Black Friday deals. And I know there'll be quite a few things online. But first of all, this week in the black products from Vortex Magic and Eric Bedard is Suspenz. We're not going to show you the gimmick that's inside here, but it's inside this little black box. Can you talk about what the effect is, Sean?
Yes, so the nuts and bolts of the effect is you start spreading a pack of cards between your hands, as if you're going to have somebody select a card, and then your hands keep getting further and further apart, so it becomes obvious that the cards in the middle are being impossibly suspended. You couldn't possibly be holding them with your fingers or anything. And then it's kind of like the kicker, you let go with one of your hands, yeah, and the cards are left floating in the air. And then you put your hands back together, you close the fan up. Now, there's variations of this, whether you can do card tricks where you find that, you know, you spread them out, you do the levitation, and then you find their card and pull it out of the packet and give it to them.
He explains a couple of routines, but they're not really
routines as such. And I think where he's made the mistake is the strength of this trick isn't that it's a pick a card, find a card trick. If you're going to do this type of suspension tricks, and there are other card suspension tricks, the much stronger trick is the cards are suspended. That's the trick. So I don't think turning it into a pick a card trick is such a great idea. And I think if this does have a use,
it's almost like, isn't it? So the download's about 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And it's almost like Eric goes through how the gimmick works and that kind of thing. And the good thing about the gimmick as well is you can use a normal deck of cards.
You can use a normal deck.
You can add this to your normal deck of cards and do this flotation effect. But it's almost as if somebody's gone, oh, that's not quite enough though, just to do that. We better put a trick at the end.
Yeah.
And the trick, I don't think, you know, you get a good sort of spider sense intuition, having filmed a few tutorials, that Eric hasn't performed this trick at the end just doing the suspension style.
Yeah, absolutely. I think if what this is, now I think magnetic cards, which is what you're going to compare this to, is a stronger magical effect.
Right.
However, I think this could be a bit of fun when you're about to have a card picked. And something that I would consider doing with it is spreading out the cards to have the card have it picked. And then go, oh, I'm not sure I've got time for this one. Have a look at my watch, leave the cards in the air, come down and go, oh, maybe we could do that. And then have them select a card. And so I'm doing it as a gag and as a throwaway thing where they go, oh, what just happened there? Rather than, like with the magnetic cards, where you're creating this like superhero type moment where the cards clip to your hands and then fall down again.
I like the effect. I like the effect. One thing I don't like about it is how long it takes, because you kind of have to spread kind of slowly.
Yeah, you do.
If you could just get those cards and go like an electric deck, then stay there and then give those cards out, that would be a lot better in timing for the way I perform.
Absolutely.
But you said that's not a problem for you because you could do it, you could talk about it as you were spreading the cards out and then make more of a comedic moment out of it because that's more your style.
Yeah.
For me, I'd like it to go a lot quicker and stay there. It doesn't do that for me, so I wouldn't use it. But I do like the gimmick. I think it's... when you kind of get it out of the box, you've got one of those familiar moments when you buy magic products, when you kind of go, is that it? But then actually, when you try it, it does work exactly as advertised.
Absolutely.
Although it's not for me, if you want to do that effect and you're happy with the cards spreading slowly, I don't think you're going to be disappointed.
Yeah.
And the gimmick is of a very nice size. As Eric explained, you can palm it very easily and you can also add it to the cards and hide it behind the cards quite easily.
Absolutely.
Indeed, during the routine. I'm not going to go overboard on it because I'm definitely not going to do it, but it's not a bad product. I'm giving it 78%.
Yeah, I was going to say 79%, so spot on again.
So very shortly, it's competition time, and you will have the chance to win Vanish Collector's Edition Year One. We've had a good look through this. We're not going to review it because of our association with Paul and Vanish Magazine. But we are going to tell you a little bit about it and give you the opportunity to win Vanish Collector's Edition Year One very, very shortly. But next up, we've got Snapped by Justin Flom and the Other Brothers. Yeah. The Other Brothers and Justin Flom, I was lucky enough to spend time with at Magic Live. Great performer, Justin, and great creative minds, the Other Brothers. That is not in doubt. So what's the effect with this one?
So what happens is you get a piece of candy, a chocolate, like a chewing gum bar a thing. I don't know what brands they are. What brand is it?
I think it's Airheads.
Airheads. So you get an Airhead stick, and then you hold it behind your pack of cards or whatever, and then you go, and it instantly and visually and audibly disappears.
It snaps. It just snaps away and kind of vanishes.
So that's it. It's a utility device that allows you to do that. And when you buy this, and they also explain some routines
about 30 minutes.
Like one of them is, because the candy stick's blue, you make it disappear, and then the person's named the card, and then the blue candy disappears.
It's almost the identical review to this, isn't it?
And it's turned into a blue card. The card that they named is then the blue card in the pack.
It's like, the trick isn't good enough, so now we need to crowbar a card.
Yeah, and what disappointed me with this one is, magicians always do this. Let's turn everything into a card trick. Yeah. So for me, if I was going to do this, I'm not saying I'm doing it the right way, but I've got lots of card tricks. There's lots of card tricks out there. If I've got something that allows me to vanish a sweet or some candy, why turn it into a card trick, right? So I would maybe be doing something like making the candy disappear and then making it reappear from somewhere else. Like I've done like disappears from here, and then instantly the guy looks at his shoulder and he's got a candy bar, so it's gone from here to his shoulder.
Yeah, or in his top pocket.
Or something like this. And I think that is a much stronger piece of magic than you then suddenly making the candy disappear and then crowbarring it into a card trick.
I think it's worth talking about what I believe to be the chain of events here of how this creative process started with Snap. I think Justin Flom had a viral marketing campaign for Airheads, and if you've seen Justin's videos that he does, I know he did a great one with Tony Tiger and Kellogg's. It was fantastic.
And what happens with it, every time Justin Flom's and Airheads get named in the same sentence, he earns money, doesn't he?
Does he?
Okay, Justin Flom, Airheads. Yeah, all the time. So anyway, we got this trip with Justin Flom and Airheads. And
anyway, he got asked to put this viral marketing video together. And in the video, obviously they had to solve a problem. And Justin's brief that he gave to the Other Brothers was, I want it to look like these Airheads that are normally this big end up getting compressed down very quickly by magic into these small sort of capsule sized chewing gum bits. And he's probably gone to the Other Brothers and gone, how can we do that? And they've created this great method. But I think it's worth bearing in mind that it does look brilliant. It looks fantastic when Justin does it. It looks great, all the different variations, but I think this is definitely 100% probably the most suitable effect for video that we've ever had on the Wizard product review, rather than something you would use live.
Yeah.
Because although the Other Brothers do supply handlings and say how easily the gimmick is to palm once it's disappeared, I do believe that it's better for camera. It's better for that straight, dead on angle. And if you're not doing something straight on and dead on, it's going to be a little difficult to hide it. Having said that, if you've got something you want to make disappear that you can attach to the gimmick that makes the Airheads disappear, essentially you've got the ability to make something long and thin, sort of ruler size,
size. They do a thing with a receipt where they hold the wallet and they make the receipt disappear from behind the wallet, and then the receipt's reappeared again inside the wallet or something like
that. So if you want to make something long and thin like that disappear in a snap on video, as part of a sting, as part of a showreel or something like that, this is going to be a great way to do it. I don't think there will be any workers taking this out of the box and saying, I want to use this I want to use it strongly.
Well, I can't imagine you putting your £2,000 suit on and going to entertain some executives at a black tie ball, pulling out a chocolate bar. You might as well make a lollipop appear out of some flash paper or something like this. It's that type of thing. You've got to decide what you're doing.
It's a different style of magic, but mainly for the angle purposes, it's not something that I'm going to end up performing. But if I had to do something on video, I'm now aware of the method. The method is very clever. It's from the other brothers. So it's something worth considering if you're using it in a viral video. Nothing else, though. I don't think you're going to work it live.
No, I completely agree with that.
I don't think so.
Completely.
It's not a bad trick like this one. It's not a great trick. It's not something that I'm going to use. I wish I'd have had the opportunity. I wish somebody would ring up next minute and say, we want to do a trick where we make curly whirlies. We're doing curly whirlies and we want them to be in a smaller pack. Do you reckon you could create some magic? You go.
Got just the thing.
I know, just the thing. But until that day, I'm not going to be using it. And I'm going to give it 80%, exactly 80%.
I'm going to go 79% again.
79%, it's becoming a regular score, yeah. Isn't it? We're going to give you the opportunity now to win Vanish Magazine's Collector's Edition Year 1. And Paul has done a great job with this book. We'll give you the opportunity to win it. Every month you can download Vanish Magic Magazine for free. Just go to vanishmagic.com and it's absolutely free. And when you realise, when you look through this book, Sean, you see the quality of the material that's in this magazine.
I can't believe it. So I know when I was a kid, Vanish Mag wasn't around.
Yeah.
And I used to buy some of the other ones. But I used to buy them. And yeah. I had to buy them and give money to people to buy them. Right. And I didn't have a problem doing that. Because some of the tricks that I use now started off from ideas that I found in these magazines. Now, what's even better, this Vanish Mag now, the resources that are around now in this online for free... they're just incredible, the information
far exceeds
that you get.
What we had when we got started.
I was trying to say that without offending the people that I used to buy the magazine.
Well, we used to have Repro magazine, didn't we?
Repro, we had
Repro 71.
Repro
74.
Yeah, sure, it's 74. And maybe 71, comment below. And there's Abra magazine, and there's Magic magazine.
Yeah. Well, Magic was a bit of a game changer. Yeah. And Genie, of course.
Yeah, but it was Abra to start with. Abra and Repro to start with.
But Vanish Magic Magazine has really kind of taken over.
Absolutely
one of the great
phenomenal
things about it being completely online, and Paul always says this, they can be instantly responsive to what's happening in the magic community at that time. Case in point, when Shin Lim won America's Got Talent, instantly there's a huge article about it, and you can read about it in Vanish Magazine straight away. Ding Yang is the cover personality on this month's Vanish Magic Magazine. And if you were at Magic Live in Vegas this year, it was literally... It probably saved the convention, actually. This one act was, like, worth going to Vegas to see. And it's Ding's story of how she worked with Juliana, Chen, and all her advisors. And it really is an unbelievable, inspirational story.
If you see her name advertised for a magic convention...
Go.
...anywhere, just go to it. Go to that convention.
It's going to be one of those acts. And I remember... The year I went to a very early FISM and I saw Marco Carvo for
yes.
the first time. And it actually blew me away. And the standing ovation was like turning on a light. Everybody just stood up. And that was the first time I saw Marco Carvo. And everybody talked about it. And who's the... Armando Lucero,
yeah.
who does The Matrix. At that very same convention, he was doing The Matrix... in a very private area. He wasn't booked as part of the convention, and it was in The Hague, and he was just doing it under the stairs. And then eventually everybody got to hear about this. And then the first night he had 10 people there. And then the next night it was like 20.
Well, did he have the music going as well?
Oh yeah,
like,
I remember. Sound system.
So when we was booked to do Ron McMillan's Day in
yeah.
International Magic, all of a sudden I heard this music near the stairs. And then I looked around and I happened to be at the area, so I was at the front like a seal. And he started doing it. And then all of a sudden, the whole stairs was full of people everywhere. There's all these people watching.
Well, on the last day, and the last day in The Hague, last day, David Burglass was there, sat at the side of him, and all these mega stars of magic there to witness this moment. And the thing is, that's what happened in Vegas with Ding Yang.
Yeah.
You had a feeling that, wow, I was in the room when this lady got catapulted into the magic big time. And, you know, and I know there's a lot of people out there, you know, banging the drum for women in magic, but I'm telling you, it's already happening.
Let's talk about some of the things, because not only have you got interesting articles that are going to help you with your business of magic, there's lots of business things in there. There's lots of just general advice about performing. There's also, God knows how many tricks in there. Some of the tricks for me that are the easiest to explain you've got the Shadow Karate by Andrew Gerard.
Which was a product. Well, not on its own, but it was part of the Conscious Magic series.
Yeah, which we've reviewed.
Using your shadow, you break a cocktail stick or a coffee stirrer.
They tell you to stop as you run your finger down the stick, and whenever you say stop, you then, just with your shadow, and then the stick breaks at that exact point. So
that's
an incredible piece of magic that is in there. Something else that's in there, 364 on one, which is 7 times better than 52-1. Which is, you have somebody think of their friend's birth date and the month and date of where your friend was born. They name it, you put an envelope out of your pocket, and you've predicted that. That's strong mentalism, direct mentalism. That is in there.
That's a Wayne Rogers effect, isn't it? Now, Wayne was a good friend of Paul's, and I think this book, in some ways, kind of a lovely tribute to Wayne, because he was an amazing creator. And I think Paul has included quite a few items from Wayne as kind of like a tribute, and it's very nice to read through. This illusion ideas from Mark Parker. This is a guy that consults for thousands of dollars at a time, and there's illusion ideas in there. My favourite article that I've read so far, and I will say so far, because it's the sort of book that you leave at the side of the bed, you flick through, you see a picture that interests you.
Well, it's not the type of book I leave at the side of my bed, David.
And you read something, like, I haven't read this one, but I would read this. How to Get Amazing Client Testimonials, Leif David. But the one I did read by Matthew Fallon was all about the proverbial standing ovation. And it's all tips about why your audience give you a standing ovation, how to get a standing ovation. And I've been a pro for quite some time now, a couple of years, and there were things I learned in that article, and I was very pleased to have read it.
And if you're a pro cabaret act, I can't, we both do standing ovation tricks.
Right? Yes, right? Try to, right?
And it's so important. If there's a way of building your act to do that, and you're on a circuit with people, and you're the guy that's going around doing that, that's worth the price of the book alone, really.
So this is what we need you to do to win Vanish Magazine, Collector's Edition, Year 1. It is the Collector's Edition, this one. It's in lovely hardback as well. We need you to comment on the show. Anywhere you see it, anywhere we're allowed to share it. Apparently, we can't share it in SME Talk Magic anymore.
But the thing,
we can't.
And I understand what
you're saying. Because we're advertising.
But we're not advertising.
So SME Magic banned us from posting. They said, no, you're too much advertising.
Because we don't advertise, because we're not selling anything.
Well, they say because we've got our name in the corner and that kind of thing, you know. We're not selling the items that we do. So SME Magic, you will not find us posting in SME Magic anymore, because I've been told off over private message saying, don't do that, you're advertising.
You're
a naughty boy.
Do helpful advice on products for our members. No, don't do
it.
And
don't give them the opportunity to win things.
Don't do
that.
At
all. For free. Because this will be, if you win this, you'll get sent out for free. Another thing that's free, as well as our advice, is the... I've gone off on one now.
What's free? What's free?
It's Vanish Magazine.
What's
so
the competition?
Download it.
What do we have to do?
Download Vanish Magic. Yep. Go to vanishmagic.com. Download Vanish Magazine for free. Especially if it's the first time, you can subscribe for free as well. You don't get spammed by the Vanish Magic Magazine team. They just send you an email every month and go, here's another free magazine. It's like the best email ever. So
well,
don't worry
do you
about
it.
Well, you've got to comment. Download the magazine and then comment what you like about Vanish Magazine. So I love Vanish Magazine, and we want to know that you've read something. We want to know that you saw something in there. So we want to know that you've downloaded it and actually had a look at it.
Perfect.
That's fair enough, isn't
fair
it?
Enough.
So comment, say, a little comment about the show. I like Vanish Magazine because and then leave a little comment wherever you see us posted, but not SME Talk Magic, because we're banned. And you could win Vanish Magazine Collector's Edition Year 1.
Ta-da! And next up, we've got quite a controversial product here.
What's that?
Well, it's Smooth by Nicholas Lawrence, but it comes with a sexist
chapstick.
Chapstick. It says chap. In England, is another word for bloke. And I want to know why it's not called like person stick. It should be called the person
Don't
stick, not the chapstick or the lady stick. This is the 21st century. I think it's a great product, but we just need to change it to person stuff on there. Okay.
So I saw Nicholas Lawrence do this live at Magic Live once again. It's getting another mention. Are you coming to Magic Live this year?
I think I might be.
Yeah.
I think something might be happening, which might mean that I'm going to go there.
Okay, all right, interesting. You heard it here first. So Smooth by Nicholas Lawrence. Nicholas Lawrence, very creative mind in magic. I use his on-off every single gig.
Yeah.
Multiple times. It's absolutely fantastic. I didn't think I was going to like this. I'll be honest with you. I thought it was a little bit, what are you going to do with this thing? And Nicholas was there on the dealer stand doing it. And I thought, like the pen through anything, I thought that kind of effect had had its day.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't going to like it. And then I saw Nicholas do it. And as with other things that Nicholas does that you kind of think, I'm not sure what that's going to look like when he does his incredible card vanish where he just brings up his fingers and it looks like it's just disappearing with green screen or something, but then you're seeing it in real life and you're going, hang on, that's actually pretty good.
That's real magic.
Yeah, that's incredible. He was doing the chapstick smooth effect, it's called Smooth, and he borrowed a bill and he literally, exactly as it looks in the trailer, You show that bill on both sides and you take that chapstick and it melts. It's not that oof moment like you have with pen through anything, with the Cornelius thing, which,
I tell you what it is.
It melts.
It's like when you put the cigarette through the coin.
Yes.
Only better, because the note can go straight, signed note can be straight out for examination afterwards. Everything can be examined afterwards.
It melts.
It's incredible.
Through. And because you brought up this design, there used to be that thing with a magic wand years ago where you do it with a magic wand and a magic wand would penetrate. Because of the design on the chapstick label, it's cleverly designed because you see the movement of the chapstick. You see this getting smaller, the end of the chapstick, as it goes in to the bill. And then, of course, you show it on the other side. And it is a penetration. It's not like a stab, a torn and restored style.
It's really magical because you watch it go through and then it's displayed on both sides. And you watch it come out again.
Yeah.
Slowly watch it come
morphs,
out.
And it's then you're just showing
it. It's
really
great.
The good thing about it is you hand the bill back, and with the handling that Nicholas supplies, it's only about a 30-minute download with it. You can immediately hand out the chapstick as well with very minimal sleight of hand, and everything could be examined and they'll never find the secret. It works very, very well. It's even a real chapstick.
It's a real chapstick.
It works really, really well. I was surprised how much I like this. I was surprised how magical it looked. If you're the sort of person that carries a chapstick around, or you were doing a street magic special or whatever, and you just wanted to borrow this, pick it up and
do you know what?
It
it's like
there.
Coffee shop magic again. You know, somebody says show us a trick, and you can pretend that you haven't got. Oh, I've not really got. Oh, I'll tell you what.
Can I borrow a banknote?
Just use that chapstick. Give me a banknote. I'm not sure about this, guys. Let me just have a look.
And when we reviewed it earlier and like looked through the download, we were saying about if you use that patter, where you said, this looks like it's real, but it's not. It actually looks like it's penetrating. Looks like it's sinking into the bill.
It's just an illusion.
And, it's not real. It's just an illusion. You can check it out. There's no damage. Check it all out. And I think if you presented it and you give time to the magic and you present it as something really incredible, just like when Nicholas performs it, it can look visually stunning. It's a casual thing. I don't think you use it in a gig environment, but I actually like it. I think it's probably the best product of this week for me. I'm giving it 85%.
Well, I like it a little bit more than that.
Go on.
Because I think it is worth just keeping in your pocket when you're going out to the cinema with your jeans on, in which case I'm not going to perform it at a gig, but I probably am going to perform it out in the real world. So I've got to give it 90%.
Well done, Nicholas Lawrence. He's a creative guy, you know. Oh, Shot Creek by Jordan O'Grady Productions, or Jordan O'Grady Presents. Upshot Creek, and it's a paddle effect, isn't it, Sean?
Yeah, it's a paddle routine. Now, first of all, if you're not familiar with Jordan's work, he has a series of routines that all end up being practical jokes on people. So you had the lungs test, you had the whistleblower.
You've got to have one. Lung test is great. Whistleblower is great as well.
So it's the next in a series of events. So it's what looks like it's going to be a silly magic trick. And it ends up giving the spectator the fright of their lives. That's the idea. So how would it work? So what in one example?
Well, you have... the thing is, it's a very different from a normal paddle. So you get this paddle that fits inside this sleeve, and the punctuation at the end of the routine, the thing that gives it the punchline, is the fact that it kind of explodes, doesn't it? Because you've got, I don't think we're giving anything away here by saying that it's got a special gimmick attached to the paddle, which when you buy some caps, like the cap guns I used to have when I was a kid, but are not correct to sell these days, if you get one of those caps and put it on there, as they open this, it is going to explode at the end of it. And the good thing about it is...
You get the stickers, so you get multiple stickers. So, for example, like the family-friendly one would be a
mouse on one side,
and some cheese on
cheese
the other.
Cheese on the other,
and you talk about the mouse and the cheese, and the mouse keeps turning into cheese, and the cheese keeps turning into the mouse.
And some dynamite.
Yeah.
A balloon and a pin.
Pop them.
And the gun, we didn't know it was a gun when we first looked at it, and the gun is, it looks like the gun dead on.
Yeah, you're looking down the barrel.
And you can put some dots or crosses in the barrels and do kind of like a what's next, or I'll start again, or turbo stick style presentation. Then you get a couple of blank ones if you want. So in the as the case with these routines, you can show the mouse, you can show the mouse trap. When you open it, you get the bang. The match, dynamite, TNT, what happens if you mix the match and the dynamite? They open it, they get a bang, pin, pop, you get the idea. We were talking about this today, and it is possible to open this, not set it off.
Well, he does say that.
Yeah, by holding on to it, but we came up with them doing it, because we said about like leaving it down, so open it, having a look like you were resetting it, and then putting it down.
Creating the curiosity of how the trick's done. So if they thought that there was two of the, say, TNTs at some point, and now that you've ended up with a TNT and a match, and they're kind of thinking, where's the other sticker? You kind of take this off and kind of go...
And then leave that back down in conversation, front of them.
And then you just wait for them to go, ah! Yeah, and
that's what's going to happen.
Because it's
very tactile. You'd want it in your hand, and I think that's the good thing about it. The only thing is, it's not really a negative, because it's more about me as a performer. I don't want that perception of me as a performer on probably every day of the year, apart from one, which is...
That is your daughter's birthday.
Yeah, or...
Halloween.
It's
cool. Obviously, it's Halloween. I think it's brilliant for scaring your own family.
Yeah.
I think anything that you can buy that makes your kids a little nervous around the house. Perfect.
What we're saying is, this is...
It's a bit of fun. It's not like if you've been bucks are going, like, say, they're a big posh dinner.
You need to steady on. You nearly got into trouble once for throwing water over one of your children.
Yeah. it's a bit of fun. It's not for walking around a big black tie event.
That's what you're not going to do. Because I don't want to be seen as that person who's pranking people. But if you're out and about with your friends, you're dressed like we've just been to a restaurant and had a fried breakfast. Somewhere I go all the time, all the waiters and waitresses know me.
Yeah.
And they always say, have you got a trick? It's a perfect thing just to have a bit of fun with them. But it's not a gig scenario, but I guess you've worked that out for yourself. But as a fun, practical joke, I actually think this is really good. The quality of the gimmick, it's pretty good. It's 3D printed, but it's going to work. The device works. I used to have a similar thing in a wallet ages ago, and you would get somebody to open a wallet and that would bang.
Mm-hmm.
A Roy Roth idea. But The gimmick itself, it's going to work. It's not a great magic trick, but as a joke, as a prank, I think it's excellent. I'm not really judging this right now as a magic trick.
No,
I'm judging it as a prank, as a bit of fun, exactly what it is to do with your friends. I think it's very good indeed. I think it's, I'm going to give it 85% again.
Yeah, I'm going to give it 86%.
So, that's it this week for the Wizard product review. It looks like The Smooth Effect by Nicholas Lawrence has just made it to the top position. Vanish Magazine, don't forget, download it. Comment below what you like about Vanish Magazine and you might be a winner and you could be getting Vanish Magazine Collector's Edition Year 1 sent to you for free. Thank you so much for watching the Wizard product review. If you cared enough to share this video or comment below, we really appreciate it. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time on the Wizard product review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
See you next time on the Wizard product review.